One of the finest methods of making high-grade steel in large quantities is the open hearth process. A mechanical charger runs up and down the line of furnaces, filling each in turn with pig iron, limestone, and steel scrap. The inside of a furnace is like a huge oven, lined with fire brick and heated by a blast of flaming gas which shoots across from one side to the other. In addition to the samples which are sent to the laboratory for analysis, a strict control is kept of the temperature of the metal. For this purpose, a pyrometer is used. A thermometer on the end is dipped into the liquid steel while the operator takes his reading from the delicate recording instrument. As the time for patching the furnace draws near, final additions of alloys are made. Steel is on the boil. The last laboratory report shows that the charge has reached the required specification. The furnace men begin to ram through the tapping hole at the back of the furnace in order to release the molten metal into the waiting ladle. The climax of 14 hours of skillful nursing and care devoted to the making of 80 tons of the world's finest steel. The bulk of Britain's steel is made into ingots, varying in size from a few hundred weight to 250 tons or more. The molten metal is poured into cast iron ingot molds. A large quantity of steel is also used for making castings. These may be anything from a small frame or bracket to the 300-ton stern plate of an ocean liner. Becomes solid, the molds containing the ingots are brought to the splitting bay where the molds are removed. Ingots are the bases of steel production. They can be rolled or forged into billets, flumes, bars, slabs, plates, rods, wheels, girders, or tubes into any of the wide range of semi-finished products which feed the world's engineering shops. Before the ingots are rolled, they are reheated to the right temperature in gas-heated chambers known as soaking pits. When the ingot reaches rolling heat, it is picked out of the soaking pit and placed on a chariot which carries it to the rolling mill. trained crew operates the mill. Silent and intent, almost a part of the machinery, they work the levers which control the movements of the ingot and the pressure of the rolls. Here, speed and precision depend on the highest order. In less than 2 minutes, the 2 foot thick ingot is rolled out into a 7 inch thick bar. As the bar leaves the main rolling mill, it is carried through a decimer, which removes any scale or blemishes that may have formed on the bar during the rolling process. The bar now passes through a battery of finishing rolls, which further reduce its thickness to 2 or 3 inches. As it emerges from the rolls, a guillotine cuts the 150-foot bar into shorter lengths. As these reach the end of the line, they are stacked on a conveyor which takes them to the final inspection bay. High-speed strip rolling produces the tin plate and sheet steel which goes into motor car bodies, belt buckles, tin cans, radio components, and 1,000 other light steel products. The steel, which forms on the surface of the slab during reheating, is blown off by a high-pressure spray of water. The 8-foot slab then passes through a series of rolls, each of which successively reduces its thickness and increases its length.